In this video, I will be defining and using names in formulas as I set up a break-even chart template in Excel. Here we have the fixed cost, the variable cost per unit, and the selling price per unit. I'm going to select the values and names, click the formula tab, and under define names, click create from selection, or simply use Ctrl+Shift+F3. Since the names are in the left column here, I will leave the left column checked and click OK. Now when I click on the named value, you can see its name in the name cell at the top left corner here. To calculate the break-even point in units, we can use the formula fixed cost divided by the unit contribution margin. So I can simply type equals fixed cost FXC divided by open parenthesis selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit, close parenthesis, enter. And the break-even point is 250 units. Now, setting up the table for the break-even chart, we need the units, fixed cost, total cost, and total revenue. For the units, we start at zero, then choose another point like production capacity if we have it. But I want to relate the unit point to the break-even point. So let's name the value of the break-even point by clicking the cell and typing BEP in the name cell here. That's a quick way to name a single cell. Now for my other point, I want to use the break-even point, 2 times break-even point, and 3 times break-even point. Note that these 3 points are arbitrary points. I have tied them to the break-even point so I could use this sheet as a model or template. Next, for fixed cost, equals FXC. Grab the fill handle and drag down. I chose to use FXC for fixed cost here to prevent naming conflicts in Excel. Since Excel is case insensitive, using FC will create problems when renaming this FC column. Now let's name this table based on its titles. Select the entire table, click Formulas, Create from Selection. Ensure the top row is checked since the name are in the top row and click OK. Now for the total cost, I can use equals FC plus VC times units. Enter. You can see that it autofills for the rest of the selection. For total revenue, I can type equals SP times units. Enter. And it auto-completes the rest. Now, suppose we have an additional point outside the selection here. If I try to use name cells to calculate its total revenue, it won't work since the selected cells for units stopped at 750. In such case, we can simply select the value. I'm going to delete the additional row. Now, suppose for some reason I want to change an individual formula in one of the total revenue cells. I won't be able to do that because the cells are in an array. One way to create an individual formula involving a named column is to introduce the at symbol before the column name. Enter. I can then copy it down to all the cells. Next, I'll construct a break-even chart by first selecting the first 2 columns, click the Insert tab, click the Scatter drop-down, select Scatter with Straight Lines. Next, right-click anywhere in the chart and click Select Data. Click Add. For total cost, TC for series name. Select units for X values. And for Y values, remove the 1 in the cell and select the total cost values. Click OK. Click Add again. For the series name, TR for total revenue. For X values, select units values. For Y values, remove the 1 and select total revenue values. Click OK and click OK. So here's the break-even chart. If I click the plus button to the right of the chart, I can add axis titles, change the horizontal title to units, and the vertical to dollars. This chart is dynamic. For example, if the fixed cost is changed to 1200, the chart automatically updates, and changing the selling price to 15 also updates it accordingly. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.